the most beautiful place in the world, where a Tar Heel blue sky blankets Murphy on its way to the Tennessee border. It's a long way from Raleigh and the Outer Banks, but we're living in Carolina too. In fact, you might call it extreme Carolina. With more, here's Michael Borkman.
Well, welcome everyone to the show, Extreme Carolina, the show that focuses on great people with great stories who prove with their lives that anything is possible. And today we are truly, truly blessed to have a really good friend of mine and a person that is proving with her life that anything is possible. And she is an amazing, amazing artist. And we recently found out she's also an author. So she's just so amazing, got talent just oozing out of her. So without any further ado, Mrs. Virginia Urani. Good morning.
Good morning, Michael.
How are you today?
I'm glad to be here. It was a beautiful drive over here with the dogwoods starting to bloom.
Yes, they are. It looked beautiful out there.
It does.
Well, let's just dive right into it. We don't want to waste a lot of time getting to it. Now, you have been on the show before because I did mention you were an artist and are still an artist, and you still be doing paintings and watercolors and all that stuff. But you've recently had a journey to a place that the artist and these people who are, I guess you would call them, just not just smart people, but creative folks, they get together in this place. So tell us about that place, okay, real briefly.
That place is called Wild Acres, and it's off the Blue Ridge Parkway near Little Switzerland. So it's up in the mountains.
In North Carolina.
In North Carolina, mm-hmm, kind of north and east of Asheville.
Okay.
And it is a place where people gather, artists, writers, musicians, sculptors, potters, and they gather in the spring and the fall. And you have a project, mm-hmm, that you work on, and the meals are provided, and you stay there, so you have a week to just spend doing your art, your music, whatever.
Ah, well, you went there to do your art, but you ended up doing something completely different from what you came there to do.
That's true.
Now, we only got a real small show, 20 minutes, so we can't really get into the entire thing. But I would like if you would tell us. Now, the book, I got it in my hand. It's a quick read. If I can say quick read, it's really fast for most other people. And I'm a slow reader, so it's a really quick read. And the book I have in my hand is called My Butterfly, A Love Story. And it's got this beautiful picture on the front. And this was the actual butterfly itself and that you took pictures of. And did you do watercolors of it as well?
I did. There are watercolors in there as well.
Oh, my goodness. She is talented, y'all. I'm here to tell you, y'all need to meet her. But anyway, so you're doing your thing. You're over there and you're getting inspiration, ready to, you know, paint and draw and do your thing when a butterfly came along.
That's
true. If you could quickly kind of tell us how, just the beginning of that, how it usually run away from you, but this one didn't.
That's true. It was about this time of year, and it was a dreary, cool day in April, mm-hmm, and I was walking down a path looking for inspiration in flowers. And there was a fluttering in the grass. And I looked down, sat down, and it was a black swallowtail butterfly. So I sat there and I said, hello. And I put a stem next to him, which he crawled onto the stem. And then I put my finger next to the stem, and he crawled onto my finger. So we did that.
This never happens.
No, they usually fly right away. And then he stepped on my finger, he walked across my hand, he walked up my arm, across my face, and disappeared. And so I sat there, and I thought, where did
Freak
he go?
Out.
Where is he? And I happened to have a phone with me, which I usually don't, and it had a camera feature. So I took it out, and I found him. And he was sitting on top of my head with his wings stretched out like he was in the sun. And so I took several selfies, and I sat there, and the mist got heavier, and I finally got up very slowly and walked down the steps into the studio, across to my drawing table, and set him on my bouquet of flowers.
Well, you took this particular picture.
Yes.
Wow. You got to get the books, folks. It's a beautiful picture. Now, I'm not going to let her tell any more of the story because we want you to get the book and read the rest of the story. But that is truly, truly amazing because they never, those butterflies, they just instinctively fly away. And it's hard to catch one, too, because they just, you can't catch them.
No. No.
And this one, you didn't have to catch. It wanted you, pretty much.
It wanted me. It did.
Unbelievable. That's so eerie, you know. It's so different, you know, that to hear that. And I'm glad that you, but you had a, for lack of a better word, a relationship came out of that.
It did. I had him. I wound up keeping him all week. I took him outside one day when it was warm and sunny on my finger, and he stayed on the side of the building in the sun. But then he was on the ground when it cooled off, and I took him back in. And then Sunday came. Mm-hmm. It was Tuesday when he found me. Sunday, I bundled him all up and brought him home and put him in my studio. I had him 12 days.
Wow. That is so amazing. You know, the book that you, and it has some of your water coloring or your water paintings. That's what they call, right? Water?
Watercolors or water paintings,
okay,
yeah.
Water painting. Because this lady is an amazing artist. She really are. I don't want to say painter, because that don't do you justice. I mean, yeah. You do much better, and it's way bigger. And I remember before, when we had you in the studio before, we talked about how you started off as a young lady out in Omaha, somewhere in Nebraska, somewhere like that.
Kansas. Missouri.
Okay, yeah. I knew it was out that way. And the Hallmark. I remember that part.
Yep.
All right, you worked for them. And so you learned your craft early on, and you have stuck with it. You've not given up that passion. And I remember you saying this, when you were a little girl laying on the floor and drawing and doing your thing, and you still have that same interest, that wide eye thing about painting and drawing that you had all those years ago.
That's true. And one of the things that's different about it now is I really love the wildflowers and the plants and the insects here. And so I use that skill to show people, try capture the feel of the flowers and the animals.
That is amazing. You do have a skill, and you capture it very well. I mean, folks, the book, My Butterfly, A Love Story, she has captured this butterfly, or one, I think it's this one throughout the book.
It is.
All right,
it is him.
The same one throughout the book. And this particular, there's a name for this butterfly, right?
Oh, it's a pipevine swallowtail. A pipevine swallowtail lays its eggs, her eggs, on a pipevine, which is poisonous. The vine is poisonous.
Ooh.
And so the caterpillar, you know, hatches out and it eats that, you know, that plant. And then when it turns into a butterfly, it's poisonous to birds, you know, and other predators. But there are three broods, and the first brood comes out in the very early spring. So this little guy was a member of that first group.
Nice. And the name of it one more time is called?
My Butterfly.
No. The butterfly
the
itself.
The butterfly. Okay. The Pipevine Swallowtail.
Pipevine Swallowtail. That is an interesting name for a creature. But it is beautiful, and it is amazing. Ah, and there's your little studio.
Mm-hmm, my little studio.
Yeah. Okay.
That's where you're meant to live.
Yeah, well, you guys got to get the book, I promise you. But what we're going to do is that we're going to have a little bit of a contest. We're not going to give away the secrets yet, so you're going to have to tune back in, everyone. But we're going to talk about, we're going to have a little contest on how you can win a copy of her book. And we're going to tell you a little bit more about it before we end the show today. But in the meantime, we want to continue on with our interview. And we're just so grateful and honored that Virginia would come back and be on the show with us again. This is fun. I really have liked it and have been looking forward to it. And one of the things that we talked about just a few minutes ago, and that was your ability to have this passion for artistry. You've had it your entire life, and you've actually had the privilege, unlike most people, to work a job in your passion. But we want to get into that. But we want to take a break right now, though, and we'll get back into that on the other side. And so we'll talk more about it, and we'll give all those who stay with us an opportunity to win a book from Virginia Uriana. We'll be right back, folks.
Tar Heel basketball, Cam's Panthers, Asheville's eclectic nightlife, and the Great Smoky Mountains. It belongs to us, too, out here in extreme Carolina. Once again, here's Michael Borkman.
Welcome back, everyone, to the show, Extreme Carolina. We have today Mrs. Virginia Uriani, and I tell you what, it's been fun. And, you know, I started out talking about she was an artist, she is that, and also an author. But off the air, I found out, well, I didn't really try to be an author. Something to happen. So I'm going to let her say what that was. So if you don't mind, Virginia, tell us about this non-author thing.
I would be happy to tell you that, Michael. Thank you. I did not intend to write a book. But this experience was so magical to me that I wanted to share it. And so first I wrote used it in a Christmas letter the year after it happened. Mm-hmm. And then after I did that, I got response to it. Plus I thought, I want to do something else with this. And I tried to think of magazines. I didn't know what to do. Okay. And eventually I decided I would make a book, and I published it myself. So it was really, it's not for me. That's the part that's really important.
Okay.
It's for the butterfly.
Ah.
It is for the butterfly.
Nice.
Butterflies are disappearing.
Yeah, they are. They are. There is and pesticide is the main culprit.
It's one of the main culprits.
Yeah, that is terrible.
And I really had a relationship with this butterfly. That was the surprising thing. I really loved him.
So unless you have another relationship with another species or animal, you probably won't be writing another book. I mean, since
who knows?
It just popped up. Okay. All right. Well, then, thank you for sharing that with us. So it truly is something you wanted to share, and it wasn't something you set out to do.
Mm-mm.
It just happened.
It's my heart.
Was her heart. She pointed at her heart, y'all. And so that is truly, truly amazing. Now, we also, while we're talking about it, what was the hardest part about taking it from your heart and putting it on paper?
Actually, the words came out pretty easily.
Okay.
But when it came time to actually lay that out in a book form and plan it, and I did the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
That was a whole different process. You know, you've got the experience,
mm-hmm.
and that just kind of flowed out fairly easily word-wise. But then that methodical, organized process was a different feeling. And then publishing it was another process. And now I'm in another one.
Oh, my goodness. So those are processes that you have never had done before.
That's true.
Because in artistry, in doing your art thing, it's a completely different thing.
It is.
Wow. You are amazing, and you truly are a wonderful lady that have some serious skills. And we're just honored to actually know you and see you around in town in various places. But I didn't know you had this skill. I mean, this is one.
I didn't either.
Because it is a great, great read. And I want everybody to really go and try to find Virginia. If they wanted to buy it, since you self-published this thing,
mm-hmm.
and if they wanted to find it, where would they go to find it?
Right now, they would simply have to contact me. I don't have it.
Is there a website or an email or something?
My email. Okay, that would be the best way.
That would be the best way? Right. Would you want to give that on the air?
Absolutely.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
My email address is Urani V for Virginia at frontier.com. And Urani is spelled U-R-A-N-I-V for Virginia.
Awesome. Say it one more time.
Urani V at frontier.com.
Awesome. Fantastic. And we will also put that in the show notes. So when people come to our Facebook page and they look to see about you and this interview, we'll have that information in there and people can contact you by way of email.
Great.
They'll email you and say, hey, I'm interested in getting that butterfly love story. And because it is a great, and I love the colors on it. And well, I am a color guy. Yeah, that's what I love colors. And this book is amazing. You've done a fantastic job. But then that's where probably the only part of your artist is that part right there, is putting the colors and things together or the pictures.
Probably a part of it, yeah.
Yeah, because you do that. Now, do you, and you were teaching once before at the John C. Campbell Folk School. Mm-hmm. Are you still a teacher there?
I'm still teaching there. Ah. I am. I'll be teaching the middle of August, weekend class in watercolor for beginners.
Wow. Watercolor for beginners. Now, have you taught this particular class before?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I many times. It's always new. You always have new people.
Yeah, because this is for beginners.
For beginners.
So the people that are listening to our show today, they hear this and they say, wow, I've always been interested in doing that. So they can go to John C. Campbell. What is it? John C.
Campbell Folk School.
Folk School. They have a website.
Yes.
They can go to the website and it has the teachers in there and the times that they'll be doing their teaching.
Yes.
Their classes, rather. Okay, so they can go to the website and find out, or they can listen to this show, and we're talking about it now. When is that class coming up?
I think it's August the 16th through the 18th. It's a weekend class, the middle of August.
Ah, okay. And you know what? We'll put that on the show notes as well. Great. So people can go to the Facebook page, find out two things about you. Actually, it's going to be three things. Well, yeah, because we're going to do that giveaway thing, that trivia. But I want to just let folks know a little bit more about you, because that's what the show is about. I mean, it's not so much to promote what people do in terms of for a living and stuff like that, because that's another show. But we like to highlight people that are doing amazing things in the community that are helping other folks in the community. And that class is got to be amazing, taught by someone that has been doing watercolors and paintings and drawing for years and years
and years.
I have another friend of mine. She just recently retired, Deb Collins. You probably have heard of her. Mm-hmm. And up in Hiawassee, her and Russ, shout out to them too. Deb, actually the homegirl of mine, we grew up in the same hometown in Chattanooga. And we didn't even find that out until here recently, about a year or two ago. But anyway, we like to highlight that sort of thing. People that are doing things that really are amazing in the community. And this is just not some kind of book that you wrote to make millions and gazillions of dollars. But I love how you said the heart. It was a heart thing. So you felt, at what point did you say, I got to let everybody know about this? When was this?
I think just maybe in the weeks or months after he was gone. That, and then at Christmas, I wasn't going to do a Christmas card in November. One morning I thought, I could do a painting of my butterfly and use it for a Christmas card. Mm-hmm. And then a few days later, this little thought came, and I could write this story because Christmas is about miracles, and this was truly a miracle.
Nice.
So.
And so the lifespan of a butterfly is how long again now?
It varies with the species. Some are just a day or two. This particular species lives 10 days to 2 weeks.
Okay.
And I had him for 12 days.
Holy mackerel. Yeah, you got almost the majority of that out of
I
that.
I did.
But we don't want to give away the end of the story. So people got to tune in and find out and go get the book. And but anyway, we're going to do a trivia, but not today. So you're going to have to stay tuned. Go to the Facebook page of Extreme Carolina, and we're going to have a trivia question on it about the butterflies or whatever. But anyway, we've run out of time. This has been so much fun. And thank you so much, Virginia. And we're going to get you to do something to end the show. But before we do that, Extreme Carolina is committed to you, our listeners, to bring you leaders and newsmakers such as Virginia that are passionate and purpose driven and making a difference by listening to their stories. So thank you so much for listening to your story. Really appreciate it. And today, folks, you get a treat. Because for the quote of today, Virginia is going to read our quote of today.
Thank you, Michael. And this quote, a friend of mine at Wild Acres, who's a poet, wrote this for me after my butterfly experience. I waited for the one who would love me and show the world what they would soon be missing before they also disappear.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. God bless y'all. Thank you, Virginia. Appreciate it. We'll see y'all next time. Peace. We are out. And I'm hoping for Riley. I can see my baby.